to understand our world and to plan for the future, we need to be able to experience the past through the record of human expression. Under one roof, we have experts who can preserve materials ranging from papyrus to digital files. And we can preserve not only a single item, but entire collections comprising of thousands or even hundreds of thousands of items.
The library is one of the largest libraries in the country. These are repositories not just of art, but of knowledge, of human wisdom. There's a big responsibility to actually look after the contents, not just for the students at Harvard, but for the whole country, if not the world.
Primary sources are the building blocks of history. They're the whole point of trying to understand the past. The students are just awed at the concept and the reality of touching objects that are hundreds of years old, that have come down to us in all kinds of complicated ways and carry a message from the past and also from all the past in between the time they were made and today.
Primary sources are the materials out of which literary scholarship is produced. We have an idea of books as abstract content, and the closer you get to the original material of a book, the closer you get to its circumstances of production and to the conditions that made it possible. It gives us a sense of what the experience, the lived experience of reading and writing was. And those are two key aspects of literary studies.
Harvard's collections span the history of human technology. We have audio, books, motion picture film, photographs, ephemera, data sets, digital files. There are some collections that are completely inaccessible without a preservation intervention. For example, the earliest known audio recording of JFK is on an aluminum disc, and we would not have been able to access that aluminum disc unless we had digitized it.
My name is John F. Kennedy. I'm going to speak this morning on a subject we've spoken of twice before.
Houghton Library is one of the great rare book and manuscript libraries in the world. Our collections extend back to antiquity and well into the 21st century. Houghton was very fortunate to acquire the collection of the writer Jamaica Kincaid. And as part of that collection, we acquired four of her laptops. We expect to be able to recover parts of her writing that wouldn't be available in paper form.
Digital preservation is also a challenge because it's a challenge of scale. As we start to deposit video that we've digitized, the digital files are enormous and the pressures for what we need for digital storage are enormous. We need to come up with new solutions and a variety of solutions for the types of formats that we have.
We often have this idea that once you put something online, it exists forever. But in fact, the opposite is the case. It will last only as long as the format lasts.
One of the truly unique aspects of Harvard as a university are the resources that we can make available for research, teaching, and learning. In order to have a collection like we do, we need to be able to store it in appropriate environments. We need to be able to take care of it. We need to be able to treat it.
Preservation and sending forward into time what's come down to us is one of the key obligations of an institution like Harvard that already owns vast quantities of precious materials.
The types of formats we have are new to us and evolving and changing, and we need to be able to meet those challenges. I'm confident we can do that. The vision is making collections accessible now and in the future. It's as simple as that.
What we need to do with library materials is understand that their value does change over time. Something that might just be a printed page may end up having a whole new set of values in the future. And so if we don't preserve that object right now, we're losing an opportunity to put it into an historical context. And that's very important to consider, that we're not just looking into the past, we're also looking into the future at the same time.
We need to be able to understand our history. There is a lot of information buried in these archives and in these journals that we don't know yet. We haven't experienced them yet, and they could unlock something extraordinary. Some modern question could be answered by what's hidden in these collections.